Hello everyone, and welcome to the second chapter of the first book of the Air Journey series. In this chapter, we're gonna do lots of exercises that prove to you that you can draw. Most of these exercises come from the Betty Edwards book, Drawing from the Right Side of the Brain. Some of my own experience in art classes, and some from different mentors and artists out there. The first one we're gonna talk about is the upside down drawing. If you haven't heard of this exercise, you should really watch this video till the end if you are interested in becoming an artist. This exercise is amazing in its power to prove how quickly you can go from a non-artist to a beginner artist in 5 to 10 drawings. It also shows the effect of shutting down your logical brain from focusing on the entirety of the object to focusing on the lines and curves of the object you are drawing. I still remember the first time I did this like 10 years ago. It was the first exercise I did when I started drawing. When I finished it, I sat silently for 10 minutes, just in state of shock. I couldn't believe I actually drew this. I said something that you're probably gonna say as well afterward. I said I'm gonna draw everything from now on upside down. I thought my entire career as an artist is gonna be drawing people upside down. But it wasn't that well, because the difference between my straight drawing and upside down drawing was crazy. It was an improvement rate of 40 to 50%. It showed me that I can actually draw, that it isn't a matter of a gift, it's just a state of mind that I need to change. The problem with drawing for non-artists is not being able to digest the large entity of an object into smaller parts, so they tend to draw the whole thing at once. But without the knowledge of perspective or form, the results will be eventually bad. By turning the reference upside down, you remove the ability from your brain to recognize the shape as a whole and force it into looking at the object as lines and curves. In short, seeing the reference image upside down is the closest thing you will ever get to having the vision of an artist without the years of practice that an artist goes through. See, artists practice years and years just to get from the level of forcing their brain to see upside down to being able to see the same patterns but with a straight upright image. Now the important thing when you do this exercise is not to tilt your head to try to see things as normal. Fight the urge to name what you are drawing in your mind. For example, this is not a foot, it's not a chair, it's not anything but lines. Nameless, faceless lines. So you can do this with any drawing you want to draw. And let's stick with drawing as a start. A photo will be a bit complicated for you to start with if you never drew before. Maybe not even portraits, just simple drawing you want to replicate. Draw it as it is at first, for comparison wise, then turn it upside down and draw it again. If you catch yourself still looking upside down or looking at the rest of the image as you are drawing it, place a paper on top of the image you are drawing and only leave out the part you are drawing before moving on to the next area. When you finish, compare the two drawings side by side and get ready to be amazed by the results. Hopefully after you do this over and over, you will train your mind to be able to see lines and shapes separated from seeing the object as a whole. This is essentially helps with building the first blocks of seeing as an artist. Since this book is all about giving you the gift of sight, it seemed appropriate to start with this exercise. This exercise is the introduction to the contour drawing method, which we will expand more on in upcoming videos. Contour drawing, which is basically outline drawing, is essential to separate your mind from your eyes and then your eyes from your hands. It's important to see things as a whole in normal life, but in drawing, your hands and eyes need to have a mind of their own. That is, if you want to draw correctly, of course. So when you start this exercise, especially the upside down part, focus on the line in one area that you are drawing, as I said, and phase out the rest of the drawing. Use paper, use your hand, use anything, or just mentally block out the rest of the drawing and follow the lines you are drawing. Don't think of it as an object or a character anymore, it's all lines. Another purpose of this exercise is to give you the confidence that yes, you can draw. You only need to think differently and practice, and you will get to where you want to be as an artist. It was only when I did this exercise that I was 100% sure that I can draw. It helped me realize that I can hold a pencil and draw something that didn't look like a childish scribble. The first time I drew something recognizable was due to this exercise. So if you are interested, get some papers and let's start drawing. Now as I was preparing for this video, I tried to do the exercise faking it as a beginner artist, but I couldn't do it. It was really funny, I forgot how to draw badly. This may sound arrogant, but I honestly don't know how to draw badly that even faking it didn't work. My brain can't see things the way it used to be before constant practice for the past 10 years. I unlearned the way I used to see things and I couldn't go back anymore. So I was in a bit of a dilemma. I didn't know how to make this video. So I finally called a friend of mine who never drew before. and I asked for his help. I told him I need him for a video I'm doing. At first he was puzzled that I called him to draw when he never drew before or even mentioned that he wanted to draw. He told me he stopped drawing at the age of 10, as we all do of course. But I told him that I needed someone to draw as a beginner and I can't do it myself. So eventually he agreed reluctantly to do the drawing and I started recording. But the problem was he didn't know how to do the digital drawing. So I spent the first few days teaching him how to use the tablet, cause he only drew in pencil 20 years ago. So I took few days teaching him about the digital tablet and how to use Photoshop and how to draw on it, but it wasn't going well. So I set up the canvas just right and told him, just draw, don't worry about anything, about Photoshop or layers or any of that. Just use the stylus on the tablet and start drawing. The feel of the tablet was the greatest issue for him, because he didn't like the feel of the tablet, because it isn't like paper. Which was the first issue for me as well when I transitioned from traditional painting to digital painting. It's always the feel of the tablet that doesn't feel right. So after all that, I started recording and he started drawing. I decided to start with an easy example first. A simple drawing of Hello Kitty. Very few lines and a simple shape. First, he did it in the normal position. And as you can see, this is him drawing it. So as he was drawing, I was writing notes on how he was doing it. He was obviously looking at the whole thing, drawing a circle as a start, then going into full details mode without even looking at the reference photo. He was spending way more time on his drawing than looking at the reference. To be honest, I didn't realize that he wasn't actually bad at drawing at all. He wasn't a complete beginner, because his drawing isn't completely bad. I expected much worse, to be honest, especially that I was much worse when I personally started drawing. So I was thinking of bringing another friend, but I thought, let's just keep this as authentic as possible. So when he finished his drawing, I said, okay, let's do something weird. And I turned the image upside down. He was puzzled as to why I'm doing this. I said, when you draw this time, only look at the lines. Don't start with the head or anything. Just follow the lines and don't look at the rest of the image. And I put my hand on the rest of the drawing so he can only focus on the top part first. The first thing I noticed right away that he slowed way down as he was drawing. This was very interesting to watch. Cause he did the first one in like 1 or 2 minutes, but he took about 4 to 5 minutes to do the second one. So already an improvement right there, in taking more time and slowing down. Next, I realized that his proportion got better. He isn't looking at the whole thing anymore, just where at he is drawing. He is still doing details in one part then going to the other, but that's okay. At this point, I can already see that drawing is much better than the one he just did, but he doesn't realize it just yet. He was looking at the reference photo way more than before. When he was done, I took over and unhid the previous one and compared the three drawings side by side. He was shocked. He didn't believe how good his second drawing was compared to the first one. He kept saying, is this for real? Is this a program doing this? I was laughing the whole time. I'm like, you just drew this and I didn't do anything. I told him the first one looked 50% like the original photo, which is really good for someone who never drew before. But the second one, you almost nailed it. It was 80% closer to the original photo. He just stood there looking at it for like 5 minutes. He just felt weird. He told me he never thought he would draw anything like this. He said if I told him this 20 years ago, he would have continued drawing back then till this day. So I told him, do you want to try again? He said, heck yes, let's do it. I told him, let's raise the level a little bit up and draw something you recognized and saw many times before. So I gave him this, the Mickey Mouse character. Right from the start, he drew the three circles out of Disney Channel logo. He wasn't even looking at the reference photo, he was going full automatic from his childhood memory of Mickey Mouse. So I was observing where his eyes were looking, and it was maybe 3 or 4 times in total that he looked at the reference photo, and the rest was completely out of his memory. That happens a lot when you draw something you know, like a portrait or a relative or a loved one for the first time. You think you know how things look like, but your brain is shortcutting a lot of details that it thinks it's not that important. Another interesting point that he did the face way too fast, maybe in few seconds, but he slowed down as he started drawing the body of Mickey Mouse. Cause that's what he focused on watching the cartoons, mostly the face, not the whole body. So when he reached the legs and feet, he is finally now looking at the reference. So now that he is done, again, I rotate the image and I told him to draw again. It was essential to cover this one up with a piece of paper because he couldn't help himself from tilting his head. The urge to see it as it is was bigger than the first one. After I covered it, he started to see lines and only lines. I can already see how close this gonna be to the original drawing. An interesting observation that he is now doing the lines over and over because I told him about the Ctrl Z thing. So he is undoing way more than he did before, trying to get the line to match the reference exactly. He never used the undos before when he was soaring through the first trial out of his memory, but now he is using it to match the lines instead of the whole image. Now he did struggle a bit when he was reaching the head part, cause now he is fighting his own brain to draw the features as features. So I decided to help him out by talking to him about his work, distracting his mind from naming things, and it really paid off. It did help him see lines over features once again. Now we reach the moment of truth. This one shocked him even more, showing him for the first time that he can draw one of his childhood cartoons. The difference between the first and the second was even more obvious in the head area more than the body, because when he was drawing the straight up reference photo, he started looking at the image more when he was doing the body more than he was doing the head. So he went from 65% to 85% improvement. And you can see that mostly in the body and the head part, even a little bit in the legs. At this point, he said the exact same thing I said 10 years ago. He said, from now on, I'm gonna draw all my drawings upside down. It's just amazing how this exercise have the same effect on people. Now I told him, let's do one more drawing. He was a bit tired and obviously bored by now, because when you start drawing, you still don't have the patience that art requires. So you do get bored faster. But he said, okay, let's do one more. And I showed him this one. He got up and wanted to leave. I said, no, wait, I'm serious. Just let's try this one. He said, look, this is too real to draw. It will look like crap. So I told him, just try your best and see what happens. Now, the interesting thing that he started to draw lines. He didn't start this one like the previous one. For some reason, he started to pick up on drawing the contour instead of the whole thing. I was amazed that in 4 drawings, he picked up the skill right away. Now, he is still struggling with the features and memory drawing, but it is a bit interesting that his style is changing. After a while, I can see obviously he was getting bored with this and started relying on memory more and more. He wasn't even looking at the original picture anymore and just wanted to get the heck out of here. It was really funny to see that this middle-aged man was drawing the horse exactly like a 10-year-old kid, because that's where he stopped drawing and the skill level stopped exactly at the same time. When he finished this, I told him, you know what? You are fried. Let's take a break today and continue tomorrow, because I knew he doesn't have any energy left since this is the most time he drew in the past 20 years. So I let him go and meet him the next day at 8 a.m. in the morning before he even go to work. I wanted him to be fresh as possible to draw the upside down horse. So we sit down and he starts drawing. He didn't need any reminders this time. So he himself put a paper on top of the horse and start drawing. He even zooms in and start drawing the horse line by line. I can already see the change in his style. It looks like he was playing a video game where he was just following the line instead of trying to draw. I can already see the difference in the drawing. The first one took around 3 minutes. This one took almost 8 minutes. 5 minutes more than the first one, with a slower and calmer drawing. When he was done, I turned the image back on, and this is the most improved drawing he got of all the previous one. It's not even comparable. It went from 30% to almost 100%. It was mind-blowing, but not surprising, since this exercise is a game changer. So before I let him go, I saw that he was in a good mood. So I asked him what was his favorite anime from growing up. He said Dragon Ball Z. So I pick up a drawing from it and tell him to draw it. He told me he drew this a lot as a kid. So as he started to draw this, I knew he wasn't gonna even look at the reference photo even once. It will be all from memory. And I was right. I was doing the same thing with the Ninja Turtles when I started drawing them. You just follow the same steps you used to do years ago. And he did. To be honest, this one isn't even that bad. It's just that there is not much details in it, since he wasn't looking at all at the reference image. He did the whole thing in 2 minutes. So when it was time to do the upside down version, it took him around 9 minutes to finish the drawing. 7 minute difference. It will definitely show in the final version. It was really nice to see the look on his face when he saw his favorite character finally done right after 20 years. It was really nice to see the happiness on someone's face when they finally draw something good. Almost 60% plus improvement on this one. So I let him go for the day and I see him one last time on weekend. With one complicated image that have figure drawing, portrait and perspective in it. This time he didn't tell me it's impossible to draw, he just went for it. Confidence was starting to build up already. Now I want you to notice how he is drawing this. He was absolutely following the lines. No more drawing from memory. No more even drawing big objects at once. He was doing the same technique but in the right way up. 10 drawings and he was already drawing as an artist. Of course, you won't have a perfect drawing in 10 tries alone. But he went from 0 to 50% in less than 1 hour in total drawing time, thanks to this exercise. He was still having problem with drawing recognizable shapes and objects, like the portrait. And when he was drawing it, his brain took over and drew the symbol of the features instead of what they actually are. But I promise you, if he didn't do the first 4 examples, this would have looked much, much worse. So after he finished, I turned upside down again and told him to draw this one last time. He starts zooming in and started from the corner. The first one took 4 minutes. This one took 7. Even the difference between the two drawings is getting shorter as we move on. It's a sign that he is trying to apply the same method on the straight upright drawing. The face is already better than the first one, but the portrait will take a while to get rid of all the symbolism attached to it from the childhood memory, since the face is the most drawn thing as a child. When he was done, the difference was a bit better, but not by far. He even did the body better in the first one. His two worlds are merging, in where he can finally draw straight up and get better details or as good as upside down. The only difference you can see is better portrait and better details in the upside down version. Before I let him go, I wanted to do one last thing. I went back to the first drawing we did, and I turned it to the side, in a place between the upright and the upside down. And I told him to draw the same thing, following the lines. Now as he was drawing it, I can see that he is finally getting the idea behind this exercise. And he did it beautifully. When he was done, I did the opposite. Instead of rotating the reference image upside down, I brought it back to its original orientation. And I told him to draw it this time, following the lines. Just like the upside down method. And he did. And as you can see him draw this, he is finally doing it right. He isn't distracted by the features, by the symbols, by the way he used to draw. He isn't drawing it the same way he did in the first one. He doesn't need me anymore to rotate the image for him to see the lines. He can see the lines correctly in the upright position. And when he was done, I brought back the first drawing he made and compared it side by side by the one he did after all these drawings. And I just told him, look, between the first one and the last one, there's at least 30 to 35% improvement. Just by changing the mindset behind your drawing. He didn't practice for years, he didn't practice for months, not even for days. The total time for his drawings are about 2 to 3 hours. And you can already see the benefit behind this exercise. Now it may take more with you, it may take more trials. You may need to do 10 drawings, 20 drawings to finally get the idea behind this exercise. But the important thing is to try it yourself. Try it with one drawing, see how it goes. Try it with 2 drawings, 3 drawings, and always compare your first drawing with your second and your third and your fourth and see how much you are getting better and better with each drawing. The best thing happened after he was done with all this, that he said he really liked to learn more about art and drawing. Because he finally drew something that looked good. This is why this exercise is important to do, to show a complete beginner that yes, you can draw something and it can look good. Of course, you won't draw everything upside down, trust me. I thought I would do that myself, but it gets better from here. And so it would for you as well. This is the first exercise of many to come that will prove to you that art is in your blood. You only need to change your mindset and you will be good to go. So with that, let's talk about your homework. Pick 5 different examples. Initially, drawings, not photos, just to make things easier for you. Start with simple drawing to more complicated drawings. Or you can even take the examples I used here in this video and draw them first right side up, then upside down, covering the rest of the drawing with a paper and focusing only on the contour drawing and lines of the image. You can do 5 in the easy mode homework, or you can add 5 more examples for each level in both ways, straight up or upside down, which will make you draw about 50 different drawings in total for the hard mode. So it's up to you. And with that, good luck with your homework. Well, I hope you enjoyed the second lesson of the first book of the AR Journey series. Much more exercises to come down the road. Before I go, I'd like to thank my Patreons who donated to my channel. If you'd like to donate, please go to patreon.com/rainwalker. Thank you all for your generosity. Alright, this is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you start drawing as soon as this video ends. I promise you, you will really, really like this exercise. It will be a life changer. Now I know the second book video should have come first before this one, but the second book videos are taking the longest time to finish since it's about the fundamentals. And I have to make sure that every word I say is correct, since the fundamentals are the most important part of learning art. So I need to recheck my work 2 or 3 times and add as much examples as I possibly can. So that's why every video from that book is taking about a month or so to finish. So instead of uploading nothing every week, I will try to slip some easier videos to make in between as I'm working on the bigger ones. So hopefully that video will come next week or the one after. Alright, that's it for now. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video.